Alright y'all, this is it. There's Uncle Johnny's down there. Just parked the car right alongside the road. You can see it. Here's the beginning of the trail. Nolichucky River, Roan Mountain that way. And we're off. It is 9:21 a.m. So I met my goal. My goal was to be started on the AT between 9 and 9:30. It's working out good. Called Michelle, said my goodbyes, did everything I had to do. So just me in the woods, me in these white blazes. It's good to be back. It's gonna be a lot of uphill today. That's what we're here for, right? Let's get started. Iconic view of Erwin, the train trestle. I think we'll get a few of them up through here. If you've ever hiked this trail before, one of the many highlights that you remember, specific spots that were just kind of above others, this was one of them. I always remember the view into Erwin right here. Gorgeous. That's actually north of Erwin. Erwin is this way, back that way, but that's looking towards the mountains. It's still close. I miss the roto tunnels. It's good to see them again. So calming. Starting to lose the road noise. There's a group of ladies behind me though. They're kind of squawking a little loudly. I hear them through the woods for sure, but they're not bothering me. There was a guy with him. He kind of disappeared. I don't know if he's ahead of me or if he was, if I just missed him. Yeah, it's been up all day. About a little over an hour in. Shelter. Actually, it's a little better than it was last time I was here. Last time you didn't even want to be near it. It's nasty. It's actually cleaned out now. It's not bad. Yep, I remember stopping here on my last time around. 10 years ago. Yeah, so this trip, that's something that's a little different about this trip. So I finished my 10-year section hike in 2022, but I want to come back out, keep coming out here, so I'm going to do another section hike starting this year, 2024, and I'm going to try to go southbound, do every section of the AT again southbound. So that should be, that should keep me busy and mixed in with some like West Coast trips and stuff. But anyway, I did this section that we're in right now 2013. Yeah, it's 2013. 2012 is when I did the Smokies and then some of this section that I'm doing. 2013 is when I came back up here at Devil's Fork Gap and hiked into Erwin with Mike Johnson. It's the first time I drove one of my hometown buddies into this with me. So I might take the pack off for a minute, take a small break. And then we'll keep moving. We're about 6.5 in for the day. See that? Close to it. There's a nice little stream. You know, we're getting close to Spivey Gap. It's getting late. I don't think I'm gonna go to Bald Mountain Shelter tonight. I think I'm just gonna throw up the tent at Whistling Gap, which I think is coming up in just under 3 miles. Yep, I'm feeling it. Spring of water here. That would be a good idea. Ooh, that was a good spot. So this is a Spivey Gap. This trail marker. Spivey Gap. Huh. Didn't show anything the other way. Here we're going. So the plan for tonight is to go like another, I think it's like another 2 miles to Whistling Gap. Perfect. Yeah, and just tent camp it. Getting close, definitely sore today. It was an early day. I've been up since 3 a.m. Barely slept, you know, the nerves and everything. I had to drive 5 hours to get here. Started hiking, as you saw, about 20 after 9. I think it's this way. All right. That's good right there, but I hear there's one more a little further up. That's where we're gonna get our water, probably for the night. Because I think we have to pack our water into this campsite. Alright, onward. Ah, we're getting close. Last peak of the day, it's literally all downhill from here. And it is, that's around 14 miles. And you see that, it's almost 5:30. So let's finish this thing up. And this is why I love the AT. It's probably, let's see, it's on my little dangly thing on my thermometer on my bag says it's 58 degrees. Feels a little warmer than that, but I don't know, maybe it is. This fleece is great. I'm glad I just chose to bring it. I was all worried about pack weight. Usually I don't count the clothes that I wear, how much they weigh. I usually don't count that in my pack weight. I've been wearing this thing almost the whole time, so I was stressing about pack weight for nothing. I think I got the right balance. That's for hiking in and rain jacket and my puffy for camp. In the past, I've just used my rain jacket as like an insulating layer, which works. You just kind of be, it has like the sauna effect, you know, keeps you warm by your own body heat. But it's kind of nasty. So I like this much better. You know, you feel the breeze, it airs you out, yet you still stay warm. Yeah, this is a Mountain Hardwear Summit hoodie. I just found it on Amazon like 3 days ago. It's awesome. Glad I got it. I used to wear the Patagonia R1. Anyway, this thing's a lot like a Melanzana hoodie, but a lot easier to get. Good morning. We are at the Whistling Gap campsite, or I'm at the Whistling Gap campsite, and there are, it is a we, because there's a few people over there. I don't know if you can, over there, you can see the tents. But not a very good night's sleep. I tossed and turned a lot. I was kind of on a slant couldn't get comfortable, but the campsite itself's pretty good. It's kind of windy, it's real foggy. You can see all that. But I got everything packed up, getting ready to take off. It is 7:47 a.m. A little slow start today, but we only got 13 miles. So we're gonna go up Big Bald Mountain. I probably won't have any views. I think it'll probably be socked in and foggy. But we're gonna try to make it to Hogback Ridge Shelter today, which I remember on my, when I came through here in 2012, 2013, whenever that was. I remember that was like ground zero for the norovirus outbreak. So I remember reading about it and getting there and like stopping and leaving as soon as I could, trying not to touch anything. So hopefully that's not the case this time. But yeah, it was a long day yesterday, harder than I thought it would be, just uphill all day. And I know we got uphill to start today, which I'm fine with, get it out of the way, because I think after we're over Bald Mountain, Big Bald, it's just kind of smooth sailing the rest of the day. So, all right, day two. Let's get at it. That tree to my list of my scary tree collection list. Looks like it has a couple of spots where eyes could just open and start talking to you. And this tree here is another one. If you played Elden Ring, you know what I'm talking about. Climb up out of Whistling Gap up to Little Bald, which is what I'm doing right now, has been nonstop. It's a challenge, but I knew it was gonna be this way. It's 2 miles straight uphill, but we're almost to the top of the hill, so yay. Once we're there, we'll go down into a little valley, and the shelter will be there, and that's where we can get some water. I can get some water. Come on, honey. I don't know where all this wee is coming from. yeah. You're only getting higher in elevation. And a little thermometer is saying 55 degrees. Good times. Almost there. I think we're only like a 0.2, 0.15, something like that, miles from the top. Oh, one more thing. We just, well, a second ago it said 5,000. We're at 5,000 feet. There it is. First time all trip. Getting up there, getting over the big first mountain. The first mountains in and out of towns are always the worst. Like going down into the Nawachucky River Valley where Erwin is, just a huge climb. River valleys. So once we're up here, I mean, we'll have little gaps we go into, like Devil's Fork Gap. But nothing like a valley until Hot Springs. So this is still getting over the lip of the can. And then the fun begins. All right, Little Bald, 9:42 a.m. Just a grassy summit. Oh, it might be an overlook down here. We'll see. The trails in Tennessee, North Carolina are so much smoother than the trails up north. Up north, you got roots and rocks. You got less of that. It's more like dirt and packed down leaves. But the difference is the elevation and the steepness. like up north, you have like short distances of super, super steep, you know, like you go a lot really high in elevation and very little amounts of time or distance. Here it's not quite as steep, but you just go forever. Just an endurance thing, but it's a flashback to my early days, because it used to kick my butt and I was younger. I'm 42 years old now, or 41 years old, I'm not gonna rush it, 41. And yeah, it's definitely not as easy as it was. I mean, I remember when I did the New Jersey, New York section with some of my buddies, I was over 300 pounds. I was wearing like 3X clothed shirts. I mean, I was severely out of shape. The worst I've been in my life. 315 pounds I topped out at. I think when I did the hike, it was like above 300, but I did it. Believe it or not, all these other guys I was with, much smaller than me, you know, I was still like outgunning them, you know, which I'm just conditioned, I guess. But anyway, coming out here, it's like riding a bike. To the Bald Mountain shelter. I don't see the shelter yet, but I see a big box. Bear box. Which I think all the shelters are gonna have for the rest of this trip. Which would be handy, because I won't have to hang a bear cable. Or hang a bear bag, whatever you wanna call it. Oh, there's bear cables over there too, man. I haven't seen those in a long time. That's a southern thing. They don't have those up north. I told myself yesterday I wanted to make sure I took a lot more pack off this, yeah, because I didn't dig any yesterday. Every couple hours, two and a half hours, I want to make sure I stop, sit down. That's a smart decision. All right, back on trail. All right, this is it. The highlight of the day, the big mountain, the big bulge. So there's a little bit of climbing left. Supposed to get some views, which I don't think we're gonna have much of, because we're pretty much in a cloud. Unless you know, as we come out above the clouds, that'd be cool. We'll see. You can see the top up there. That's cool. Oh, it's like a tunnel. Spooky. Sheldon graves are supposed to be up this way. Some old Civil War soldier graves in the middle of the woods. This kind of weather, it could get a little spooky. Last time I did this, it was probably getting to be pitch dark. I was coming the other way, it was nighttime. I was having real back cramps in my legs. You know, a platform over there. Look what that is. You see that? Huh. A tent bed? No way. There's no way. It's cool. Here's where the real balls begin. Look at this. Reminds me of the Whites a little bit, doing it this way. That really does. Reminds me a little bit of where was that? I've had fog like this before. Oh, the Grayson Highlands. Yeah, the first time I went through. I can see how in the fog it could be really easy to get turned around up here, not know what direction you need to go because everything looks the same. But us going southbound, keeping these markers on the right hand side, is how I know to not get lost. It's the only way without pulling out the GPS, I guess. But, so that's a waste of time. This is Big Bald, approaching the summit. Might still have a little ways to go, I'm not sure. I think we're right there. Certainly just opened up on us. Me. Never get used to talking to a camera. It's amazing the range of settings you can have when you're up on these bald mountaintops. Like when there's no fog out and sunny, you feel like the world's so big because you can see for miles. Yeah, if it's foggy, you can only see like, I don't know, 100 feet ahead around you. You feel so... world feels so small. I love it. Never gets old. Is this the summit? It might be. Oh, close to it. It's a road that goes up to the summit. Approaching the Big Bald Summit. There's the marker. Oh. You turn around up here. You see that? Big Bald. You can't read the elevation anymore. Huh. Anyway, we're 5,500 feet. Elevation. I heard people getting shuttles picking them up from up here before. It'd be kind of wild. I still got pictures when I was up here going NOBO last time. Jocelyn's with it. Yeah, it's good times. Elevation 5516. First mountain, first peak bagged of this hike for me. So we're up, we're over the lip of the canyon. So let's go. I just passed a couple NOBO section hikers. I sent out for 2 weeks. It's like what I've been doing for the past 10 years. You know, I just saw myself 10 years ago going through here. I like the SOBO aspect. It's different. You see a lot of people, you pass a lot of people. I've only seen a group of two, maybe three people who were out doing a section hike going SOBO. Bypassed them yesterday. Haven't seen or heard from them since. So nobody else. Everybody else is NOBO. I kind of like it. It's different. God, these trails are so smooth. Fog's starting to dissipate a little. Or maybe I'm just in a small clearing. Yeah, it's all foggy out there. Big boulder field. Just hit some trail magic. Somebody left a whole cooler full of Girl Scout cookies. Oh, they're amazing. I got them baggied up like this. I already had one. I'm taking a second bag with me. I did sign the register. Taking people's trash too. I don't really want to take my pack off, but I will certainly appreciate this, whoever brings us down here. We definitely appreciate it. That just made my day. Oh, that was so good. All right, here we go. There is just nothing easy about the AT. The whole thing. Ups, the downs, the rocks, the roots, and now it's raining. It's okay, I knew it was supposed to rain. I think it's supposed to rain harder as the day goes on. So, I'm feeling I might be getting the rain jacket out before too long. Right now, the canopy's protecting me, but as soon as that canopy starts dripping, I'll need it. All right. So I've officially stopped to take off the rain gear, or put on the rain gear. I am no longer a bright orange bear. I'm a black bear. So, I like this rain jacket too. This is the Enlightened Equipment Visp rain jacket, I think it is. Love it. Absolutely love it. This, I was planning on using this as like my main base layer, because even though it's paper thin, it still locks your body heat in. And it's like a sauna, but it keeps you warm, so it can be used as a base layer. I was going to use it as my mid-weight, like while I was hiking. Last minute, I decided to buy that Mountain Hardwear hoodie, that orange one that I've been wearing, and I'm so thankful I did. I mean, this is okay, but that thing is just amazing. I love, it's one of my favorite, probably one of my all-time favorite gear purchases, I think, so far. I'm not seeing any reasons not to like it. I love that thing. We'll see how it is at the end of this trip, though. Could be tattered and torn and ready for the garbage can. Ooh, that's a long way down. That probably is, too. Look at that. stop, Sam's Gap. On the other side of this mountain. I don't know, it goes like all the way over there. Wraps around and goes up. Pretty cool. That'd be some fun sled riding. Gorgeous. You can tell I'm almost to Sam's Gap. You can hear the tractor trailers going over. Sam's Gap is the it's the state line. It's a mountain, and it's the border of Tennessee, North Carolina. So, like, the interstate, and it's Interstate 26. So, Interstate 26 goes up a huge mountain, and at the top is Tennessee, North Carolina state line. And that is Sam's Gap. That's where we're crossing the highway at. So, yep, almost there. Have to go through a gate. Here is Sam's Gap. Parking lot. Interstate 26. Tennessee, North Carolina state line. I think we're getting ready to go right underneath that underpass. So that way to Tennessee. This way to North Carolina. Popular trailhead. I think there's a hostel around here too. That guy said that he got attacked by some dogs up that way. Not really attacked, but they were like a standoff with him and one of the other hikers going through too. He kind of insisted on walking with me back to the Gap. He's a peak bagger. He's going around trying to get like all the 4,000 footers in the area or whatever. Talked to him for a minute. He's from New England. He's from New Hampshire. Likes to come down here in the spring. State Line Cemetery. Oh, we're gonna have to go all the way up. I think it peels off right here. This little electric thing. Sam's Gap. That's the way I remember seeing it. Just coming out of the woods right here. Yeah. Side trail I will not be visiting. High Rock. It's gonna be a lovely view. Almost to the Hogback Ridge shelter. Just past High Rocks. There we're up out of the officially out of Sam's Gap now. We just gotta find camp. Less than half a mile. Water. Camping water. Alright, approaching the Hogback Ridge Shelter Junction. I see a notice on this tree. I don't know what it is. Shelter's that way. Signs for the morning. Back Ridge. Devil's Fork Gap 6.1. Alright. Bears are in the area.
Yep.